Hello everyone, a warm welcome to all of you in this video lecture. As you must be aware, we are doing the chapter Should Wizard Hit Mommy by John Updike. In the previous video, we had discussed how the father, that is Jack, is telling a bedtime story to his 4-year-old daughter, Joan, and how little Joan is asking so many questions out of her innocence and curiosity. Also, we were at that point of the story when Roger Skunk had gone to the wizard's house to change the way he smelled because all his friends used to run away from him, and the wizard had agreed to transform the foul smell of Roger Skunk into the pleasant smell of roses. So today we will continue from page number 52 in your book Vistas and the first paragraph. I read, he paused as the rapt expression widened out from his daughter's nostrils, forcing her eyebrows up and her lower lip down in a wide, noiseless grin. An expression in which Jack was startled to recognize his wife feigning pleasure at cocktail parties. So, as the father spoke the magic spell, little Joe was full of awe and wonder, and her expression resembled that of her mother at cocktail parties. So, the magic happened. And there was the pleasant fragrance of roses all around, and the magician charged Roger Skunk 7 pennies for this task. Okay. Daddy, what? Roger Skunk? You said Roger Fish? Yes, Skunk. You said Roger Fish. Wasn't that silly? Very silly of your stupid old daddy. Where was I? Well, you know about the pennies. Say it. Okay. So, Jack had by mistake said Roger Fish instead of Roger Skunk, and it was caught by the attentive daughter, and she said that it was so silly of her father. In order to hurry up and to finish the story, and also to avoid more interruptions, Jack agreed that it was indeed silly of him. Then he said that he would skip the part of the pennies, as it was well known to his daughter, but she demanded him to say it anyway. So this is how we often see little children behave and have things their way. Okay, so moving on, Roger Skunk said, but all I have is 4 pennies. And he began to cry. Joe made the crying face again, but this time without a trace of sincerity. This annoyed Jack. Downstairs, some more furniture rumbled. Claire shouldn't move heavy things. It wouldn't be their third. Okay. So Jack continues, and when he hears the rumbling of furniture in the house, he worries about his wife, who is expecting their third child. Then he continues. So the wizard said, oh, very well. Go to the end of the lane and turn around 3 times and look down the magic well, and there you will find 3 pennies. Hurry up. So Roger Skunk went to the end of the lane and turned around 3 times, and there in the magic well were 3 pennies. So he took them to the wizard, and he was very happy. And then he ran out into the woods, and all the other little animals gathered around him because he smelled so good. And they played tag, baseball, football, basketball, lacrosse, hockey, soccer, and pickup sticks. What's pickup sticks? It's a game you play with sticks. Like the wizard's magic wand? Kind of, and they played games and laughed all afternoon, and then it began to get dark and they all ran home to their mommies. So when Roger Skunk doesn't have enough money to pay to the wizard, the wizard tells him about a place near a magic well where he would get the money. He goes there and does as he is instructed by the wizard, and then he finds the money over there and he pays it to the wizard. When he runs towards his home, other animals are attracted to his amazing smell, and that is the smell of roses. And they no more run away from him, so they play all sorts of games together. When Jack mentions the game Pick Up Sticks, the intelligent little Joe associates it with a magic wand. So we see how the author has beautifully explored the child psychology in this story. Children generally learn things by association and resemblances. So Jack continues his story, telling Joe to listen carefully as it is going to be very interesting further. Joe was starting to fuss with her hands and look out of the window at the crack of day that showed under the shade. She thought the story was all over. Jack didn't like women when they took anything for granted. He liked them apprehensive, hanging on his words. Now, Joe, are you listening? Yes. So, Joe thought that the story is over. Like all the animals, they played together with Roger Skunk and then they went to their mommies. So, Joe thought that it was the end of the story. But, the Jack had more to say in the story. So, he asked Joe why she was not paying attention. So, he tried to gain her attention back and she said that she was listening. Okay. Because this is very interesting, Roger Skunk's mommy said, "What's that awful smell?" "What?" And Roger Skunk said, "It's me, mommy. I smell like roses." And she said, "Who made you smell like that?" And he said, "The wizard." And she said, "Well, of all the nerve, you come with me and we'll go right back to that awful wizard." So, this is a turn in the story. The story takes a very interesting turn. When Roger Skunk's mother doesn't like the rosy smell of her child, even though the other animals do like the smell, she says that they will go right then to the wizard. Okay? Joe sat up, her hands dabbling in the air with genuine fright. "But Daddy, then he said about the other little animals run away." Her hands skittered off into the underbrush. "All right," he said, "but mommy, all other little animals run away." And she said, "I don't care. You smell the way a little skunk should have, and I'm going to take you right back to that wizard." And she took an umbrella and went back with Roger Skunk and hit the wizard right over the head. So once again, Jack is interrupted in his storytelling by Joe when he misses a little point. This shows how attentive his little daughter is and how the little children take care of all the little details. So we again get to see the child psychology over here. Like little children, when they play certain games or when they read something or when they observe something or when you tell them something, they have a line, a trace of all the minute details, and even if it misses one point, then they have questions about that. Okay? So it is very difficult to sort of convince little children. So, Roger Skunk's mother is not at all convinced by whatever Roger has to say, and she says that Roger Skunk smells perfect before and just like a little skunk should. And so she finally takes little Roger to the wizard once again, and with an umbrella she hits the wizard right over his head. Now let us see what happens. "No," said Joe, and put her hand out to touch his lips. Whose lips? Her father's. Yet even in her agitation did not quite dare to stop the source of truth. Inspiration came to her. Then the wizard hit her on the head and did not change the little skunk back. ओके सो हियर जो इज अ काइंड ऑफ एजिटेटेड व्हेन शी हियर्स दिस काइंड ऑफ एंडिंग टू द स्टोरी बाय हर फादर एंड व्हाट डज शी से शी डजंट एट ऑल लाइक द एंडिंग ऑफ हर फादर एंड शी सेज दैट इंस्टेड ऑफ दैट व्हाट हैपेंड वाज दैट व्हेन जॉर्ज स्कंक्स मदर टुक हिम back to the wizard, instead of her hitting the wizard hit her on the head and did not change the smell of Roger Skunk. Okay, so Joe's father doesn't like Joe's ending either. So he rejects that once again. Let us see. No, he said. The wizard said, okay. And Roger Skunk did not smell of roses anymore. He smelled very bad again. But the other little, okay, so father has cut short the whatever the daughter has to say, and so she is kind of simpering and she is not satisfied, okay. Little Jo is not at all satisfied with her father's stance and has her own reasons, which the father kind of ignores. So Jack is ignoring whatever she has to say. Because she is not able to complete her sentence. Joan, it is Daddy's story. Shall Daddy not tell you any more stories? So, here the father seems to get annoyed. And already he was tired and he did not want to tell the story. But even after all this efforts, what he is facing? He is facing questions and he is facing dissatisfaction from his child. So, there is no question of sleep at all. Her broad face looked at him through sifted light, astounded. Okay, this is what happened then. Roger Skunk and his mommy went home and they heard woo 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 and it was the choo-choo train bringing Daddy Skunk home from Boston. And they had lima beans, celery, liver, mashed potatoes and pie oh my for dessert. And when Roger Skunk was in bed, Mommy Skunk came up and hugged him and said he smelled like her little baby skunk again and she loved him very much. And that's the end of the story. So Joe's father Jack gets annoyed, like elders generally do when they have to answer many questions. And he says that it's Daddy's story and he kind of threatens her that he will not tell her any more stories if she behaves in this manner, okay? And very quickly, he gives a conclusion to the story and there it ends. But Daddy, what? Then did the other little animals run away? No, because eventually they got used to the way he was and did not mind it at all. What's eventuality? In a little while. So what Joe is concerned about Roger Skunk's story is the running of his friends. She wants to ask her father another question, whether the little animals ran away from him or not after the smell was changed once again. So her father somehow convinces her, telling that the other animals also accepted Roger Skunk the way he was. Now what's Joe going to say? That was a stupid mommy. It was not, he said with rare emphasis and believed from her expression that she realized he was defending his own mother to her or something as odd. Now I want you to put your big heavy head on the pillow and have a good long nap. He adjusted the shade so not even a crack of day showed. And tiptoed to the door in the pretense that she was already asleep. But when he turned, she was crouching on the top of the covers and staring at him. Hey, get under the covers and fall fast asleep. Bobby's asleep. She stood up and bounced gingerly on the springs. Daddy, what? Tomorrow I want you to tell me the story that the wizard took the magic wand and hit that mommy. Her plump arms chopped forcefully right over the head. Okay, so we see that little Joe is still not convinced and she has another turn to her father's story and asks him to tell her the story that she likes with the ending that she likes the next day. Okay? No, that's not the story. The point is that little skunk loved his mommy more than he loved all the other little animals, and she knew what was right. No, tomorrow you say he hit that mommy, do it. She kicked her legs up and sat down on the bed with a great heave and complained of springs, as she had done hundreds of times before, except that this time she did not laugh. Say it, Daddy. Okay? So, just like little child behaves generally, when things don't happen according to them, they throw their hands, legs, and they are all like kind of rebellious. So here little Joe is also behaving in the same manner, and she really really wants her father to tell the ending that she likes, okay? But her father is again adamant to whatever he wants to tell towards the end of the story, and he completely says no, okay? And Joe is still not kind of getting convinced with him, and he is completely kind of irritated. Well, we'll see. Now at least have a rest. Stay on the bed. You're a good girl. Okay? So he somehow tries to convince her by saying that she's a good girl, and he will see what he can do the next day. Okay? So by saying all this, he wants her to go to sleep. The tired father that he was, he said that he will consider it another time. Okay, and then he goes downstairs. He closed the door and went downstairs. Claire had spread the newspapers and opened the paint can, and wearing an old shirt of his on top of her maternity smock, was stroking the chair rail with her dipped brush. Above him, footsteps vibrated and he called, "Joan, shall I come up there and spank you?" The footsteps hesitated. Okay, so when he came down, after telling Joe the story, he could hear footsteps which told him that despite the time and energy and questions and everything, little Joe had yet not fallen asleep, and he finally had to scold her, and then finally she slept. "That was a long story," Claire said. Who is Claire? Claire is Jack's wife and Joe's mother. "The poor kid," he answered, and with utter weariness, watched his wife labor. The woodwork, a cage of moldings and rails and baseboards all around them, was half old tan and half new ivory, and he felt caught in an ugly middle position, and though he as well felt his wife's presence in the cage with him, he did not want to speak with her, work with her, touch her, anything. Okay? So this is where the story ends, and the story ends on a very unsettling note, where neither the daughter is convinced of her father's end to the story, nor does her father like her childish stance to the conclusion. It is very a complex situation in his mind, and also in the daughter's mind, we can say, but it is more complex for the father because he is a mature person, he is an adult. He cannot and doesn't want to share whatever is going on in his mind with his wife. The author describes this situation as an ugly middle position. So why is it an ugly middle position? Because Joe's end to the story doesn't sit well with his adult morality. What the adult morality tells us, that mother, the position of a mother, the relation of a mother is a respectable relationship, okay? And it is, a mother is a respectable person who cannot be hit at any chance, who cannot be hit at any circumstances. So he was all the time confused, and when Joe had told that she wants to hear the story where the wizard hit the mother, so Jack protested. He kind of protested to her end because he had in his mind his mother, maybe, and Joe's mother, that was his wife. So both these ladies were somehow respectable to him, and they were someone whom he really loved, and he had great reverence for them. So he did not really want that to happen, because if he says that, then little Jo, as a child, she will have this idea in her mind that it is very much fine to hit mothers and to disrespect them. So Jack did not want to tell this, but the child psychology, the mind of little Jo, was running the other way. It was not something of disrespect when you see it from her perspective. It was something very innocent and something very fine and practical according to the story. It was logical for her because Roger Skunk was someone like her after all. He was also a little child and whom she really liked to smell good. Okay, so obviously she will not like someone of her age or someone with whom she has some resemblances to have a foul smell maybe. So this was maybe going on in her mind. So, and she also doesn't like the idea that his friends run away from him, because time and again she says this point and asks questions relating to this. So we see that it is a matter of great concern to little Jo. And so she doesn't want it to happen. She doesn't want Roger Skunk's friends to either run away or and their understanding of Roger Skunk's smell towards the end is not something that little children often do. They really have problems when they don't like something and it is as it is. Okay, so you have to do things according to them and they don't do things according to you. So this is the innocence of little children, which is portrayed in the character of little Jo. It is very beautifully described, the psychology, and because whenever we are small or we were small, all we cared about is pleasant things, friends, games, and all things of this sort. So this is how the story ends, and there are many questions towards the end of the story for the readers to solve themselves. There are many threads which we have been left to weave our in our own possible ways. Okay, so think about the story, think about the ending to the story, whatever you think should be the end to the story, or if you like it the way it is, with a loose end. So this is how we end today with this text complete, and in the next lecture we will hopefully do the question answers, and that will be the wrap up of this chapter. So until then, stay safe. Thank you and see you.